In the mighty name of Jesus, I bless your holy name, Lord, for this privilege you are giving to me to speak to us on this very vital topic. My dad, I pray, Lord, that you touch the heart of every hearers. Lord, as many that hear my voice today, let the Holy Spirit give them the conviction to receive your word gladly in the mighty name of Jesus. I bless and worship you, Lord. Thank you, everlasting Father, for you alone are God. There is no one beside you. Blessed be the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. My brethren, it is very wonderful to speak to us on this very vital topic that says Islam is a false religion. And the people is going to say, why is this man of God? Is he judging? Don't judge. It's God that we judge. Why are you condemning other religion? If you're not an Islam, does it mean you have the right to condemn or say anything about them? My brethren, I am not judging. I will not judge anywhere. But we must point out things that are wrong. That religion is demonic. We are considering this on part one. Many of you must have listened to the part two of it, because this part one is very vital. So, let's open our Bible to Malachi chapter 3, verse 18. Then shall you return and design between the righteous and the wicked, between him that serveth God and him that serveth him not. My brethren, do you see what the Bible is telling us? In Malachi chapter 3, verse 18. This word I have just read now. Then shall you return and discern between the righteous and the wicked, between him that serveth God and he that serveth him not. So that is what I'm doing here. I have known the religion that's serving God, the righteous, the one that's serving God, and the wicked. Islam is wicked. They are not serving the Lord. Many people have been misled because of what is written in the Quran. And they're going to tell you, Abraham is in Quran. So Bible characters, they're in Quran, which means it's spiritually inspired book. It's not true. It's not spiritually inspired, but demonically inspired book. I can back it up. So, don't feel that I have nothing to say that I'm coming to condemn other religion, but I'm teaching our people, because the Bible says, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. If the truth will not be spoken, people will not know where they are and what they are following. They will think that they are in the right place, and that is why you see them, they are all the time fighting for their religion. Once you make mention of Muhammad, a Muslim is there to kill you. He can bring out a knife and stab you to death. Because they thought that they are in the right way. They thought that they are in the right track. They are running a race that will usher them into everlasting kingdom. But they do not know. They are running a race that will end them in doom and a total calamities. But I want to let them know today, that is why I have to entitled this message, Islam is a false religion, and you have to escape for your life. Some fighting for Muhammad. If they say something about Jesus, a master, and you say anything against him, it's between you and God. My Bible tells me that every sin against the Holy Ghost will not be forgiven, but every sin against the Son will be forgiven. So am I going to fight for him that fights for me? How am I going to fight for my creator? I don't fight for Jesus. Christians, we don't fight for our God. Our God is a living God. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 30 to 31. You know the Bible very well. It says, vengeance belongeth unto the Lord. I will repair, says the Lord. For the Lord shall judge his people. In verse 31, he is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. So if they said the Muslims are saying things against our God, they are killing the children of the living God, our God will fight the battle for us. Our God will put an end to theirs. Our God will judge them. And he has reserved a day to judge them. And the people are saying, why? Which is the day the Lord is going to judge these people? Let's take laws into our hand and fight back and destroy them the way they are destroying the Christians, the believers. In 1 Peter, in 2 Peter chapter 2, 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 9, the Lord knoweth how to deliver the godly out of temptation and to reserve the unjust unto the day of judgment to be punished. My fellow believers, we should not be worried. The Lord has a way. He has reserved the unjust unto the day of judgment to be punished. They are going to be punished. They will not go scot-free. The Bible says, though hand joy in hand, the wicked shall not go unpunished. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 21. You know the scripture very well. So what I'm saying in this aspect, we are pointing out the evil that are going on. When we see that a particular religion is not inspired of God, but they're claiming that it's inspired by God, why are they going about killing other people? Why are they slaughtering other religion, other believers? Why are they burning churches? Why are they gangsters? Why are they map us as their enemies? Because we are not the same with them. We are not the same with them. Our God shall judge them. So anyone who is against the living God, the true God, the everlasting Father, against the children that follow Him, the genuinely born children of God that come upon their master, our God will fight for us. 100%. He will fight for us. He has reserved a day of judgment to punish all those involved, all those Boko Haram, all those ISIS group that are involved, terrorists involved. Because when you look at it, the root of all these Boko Haram and ISIS group is Islam. They all come out from Islam. Whether they call it Sharia law, they take their root from Islam, Islamic religion. Sharia law, they practice the Sharia law. They want to compel everybody to follow that law. There is a problem in the world today. There is a problem that going on in the Middle East. There is a problem that going on in Nigeria. There is a problem that going on in Cameroon. There is a problem that going on in all over the countries, because they want to force the government to introduce Sharia law, where people will be moved or motivated or compelled by the government to follow a particular law they call Sharia law, and it's not gonna work out. It will not work out in the name of Jesus. They have their law, but our God, He has given the freedom for everyone. If you receive Christ, you receive it for your own benefit. If you renounce Jesus today, it's your own business. Christianity is not a religion of violence. We are not people of violence. We are people of peace. We are people that your conscience tells you what you are doing is wrong and you have to make an amendment. Christianity is open for everyone. It is not a mandatory, it is not a compulsory religion. We force not people to be part of it. But if you are convinced by the Holy Spirit, because you know what awaits for those who do not know God and to those who are not following the way of the Lord, is a religion that you must take decision by yourself without anyone comparing you. You have to decide where you're going to spend your eternity. You're going to decide who you're going to serve. Whether you're going to serve your Creator or you're going to despise your Creator and then live your life the way you want to live it. So in Christianity, we don't force people, we don't compare people and say everybody must be a Christian, otherwise we have to kill you. And the Muslims are doing it. Everybody must be a Muslim. Without that, you are an enemy. Number one, that's to show you it is a false religion. But a religion that gives people the freedom to take decision, to take the step, to follow the one they want to follow without comparing them. The one you'll be convinced in your hearts that this religion is where I want to follow, is where I want to worship the God. That's to show that Christianity is the right religion. because my master proved it to us. Jesus said it in John chapter 14, verse 6. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh to the Father but by me, not by Muhammad, not by Buddhism, not by Judaism, not by any other way, but through a mercy of Jesus. Anyone that want to come to the Father must come to through him. I want to tell you, he has given us a conscience, freedom to choose who you're going to serve, to choose who you're going to follow. That is what the Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 8. In flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of Lord and from the glory of his power. Those that refuse to accept Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior, and those who do not know, if you don't know God, it's not going to be an excuse. If you know and you refuse to obey the word of God, it's not going to be an excuse. That person shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power. And I told you before, and as I'm telling you right now, that Christianity is a matter, is a religion of choice. You have to choose. You have to decide. The Lord is not comparing you. Our master is not comparing you. We are not fighting for him. He is the one who fights for us. He is the one that colors. He calls everyone. But he gives you the privilege to make a choice. Who you're going to choose. Who you're going to follow. He's not going to compare it to yours. Now today you must follow me. Anyone that not follow me, I'm going to kill that person. Stop that person. He is an enemy. Have nothing to do with such person. Some people are evil because they do not follow me. Jesus never taught us that. And he will never teach us that. You understand what is Christ is telling us today? But he has called us and said, which step do you take today? In Deuteronomy chapter 30, we are reading from verse 19. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you that I have set before you life and death, blessing and curse. Therefore, choose life, that both thou and thy seed may live, that thou mayest love the Lord thy God, and that thou mayest obey his voice, and that thou mayest cleave unto him, for he is thy life, and the length of thy days, that thou mayest dwell in the land, which the Lord sware unto thy fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, to give them. Do you see what the Bible is telling us here? He has called you. He has called me. He says, choose it this day. Do you anywhere? Which one do you want to choose? He did not put it or compare it. You must follow me. You must choose my way. No, but he gives everyone the privilege to make a choice. Choose you this day who you serve. Do you understand me? So that is why I can prove that Christianity is the right religion for everybody to return to their creator. And Islam is a false religion, a very big one. And you see what the Bible tells us in Galatians. Let's read Galatians chapter 1. You will see clearly what Paul the apostle says there. And I want to tell you that anyone who is following Islamic religion and other religion, they are cursed people. I am not the one that says so, but it is the word of God that proves it to us. And that is why I can say boldly what the word of God has proved, that it's genuine and it's real. Here we see in Galatians chapter 1, reading from verse 6, I marvel that you are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel, which is not another, but there be some that trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. There will be some that trouble you, that will pervert the gospel of Christ. They pervert the gospel of Jesus. Islam religion perverts the gospel of our Lord Jesus. No, but though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. Do you see what I'm saying here? And do you know Muhammad? He claimed that his angel that gave him the Quran, Angel Gabriel, that is what they claim in the Quran. And if that is the case, Paul has known that there will be a time like that, because about 1,500 years, the Bible came into existence before Quran. And we see that what the claims of Muhammad, when Muhammad came, he claimed that Angel Gabriel gave him the Quran. And he was inspired by Angel Gabriel to put down the Quran. And he see that he is accursed already. Muhammad claimed that Angel Gabriel revealed the Quran to him. In Quran, you can find this in Surah chapter 26, verse 192 to verse 195. It is written there that Angel Gabriel handed over the Quran to him. And Paul said, But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let it be a curse. So the Islam, they are cursed already. They are cursed children. They are cursed. And anyone that follows that religion is accursed, because it's different from what the foundation of the Almighty God has laid through His Son Jesus Christ. That through Christ, everyone will return back to Him, not through any other name. Muhammad didn't die for Quran, he didn't die for his people. But our Master Jesus, He died for our sins, He gave Himself for us, He shed His blood for us. His blood is for the cleansing of our sins today. That is why we are cleansed by the precious blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I can declare it to you that Jesus is the only approved way. He's the only way anyone can return to the Father. There is no other way. And we don't fight for Him, He fights for us. As He has spoken to us, He has reserved the unjust for judgment to be punished. The day of judgment that is going to punish them. But the people that have refused to walk in His way, they are going to face the punishment of God. So, you see, any other religion, not only Islamic religion, any other religion that is not, the foundation is not Christ, it is only Christianity that the foundation is Christ, our Lord Jesus. He is the founder, He is the author and the finisher of our faith. It's in Christ Jesus that the word of God has been planted, and the word of God has been propagated to teach us the will of God for mankind. So any other religion, they are leading you to destruction. I make emphasis about Islam because they are the one that has called the Christians their enemies, and they are the one that are going about killing, making problems, and being used by the devil, their father. But I want to let you know today, open your eyes and come up from that Islamic religion. If you are still there, you are cursed. The Bible told us that. As we said before, so say I now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that you have received, let him be accursed. Let him be accursed. Let him be accursed. Two times to tell us if the Bible make a reputation is a very serious matter. And here the Bible has made reputation in verse 9 and also in verse 8. He repeated the same thing. Let him be accursed. So Islam, the people that follow Islamic religion, they are cursed. The people that follow Hindu, they are cursed. The people that following Buddhism, they are cursed. People that follow Judaism, they are cursed. Any other religion, paganism, they are cursed. They are cursed. They have to repent today and come to Jesus and embrace Jesus. All these are false religion. The Lord, the Almighty God, is calling, inviting you He doesn't know that way. He only know only one way, and that way is Jesus, his son. He is the only one he prescribed. He is the only one he has given to us. He is the only one he called us that we should follow him. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. But if you do not believe in Christ and you follow any other religion beside Christ, you are waiting for the wrath of God. The wrath of God abides for you. It's waiting for you. You know that? Maybe you don't know that. That's why I said I have to take time to teach this word. And I'm not judging, but I'm telling the truth. I'm telling the reality, what will help you at last. That you are not going to end up miserably, but you repent today and come to the right way. And forsake those evil ways you're going. Those religion with their way they are teaching you values. Those religion with they are teaching things that will not lead you to anywhere. In John chapter 3, reading from verse 36. He that believeth on the Son has everlasting life, and he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him. Do you see it? If you don't believe in Jesus, if you don't believe in Jesus, if you don't believe in the Son, if you have not given your life to Christ, the wrath of God abideth on you. You are under the wrath of God. You are cursed. That is why you have to walk out of that place today and walk to Jesus, our Master, our Lord, our Savior. He is a way, he is a truth, he's a life. Let's follow him. He's leading us to everlasting life. He came because of us. He came for the world. But the devil has brought all this religion to blind the mind of the people, to separate them from the real way, from the right way, where they're going to be free, where they're going to serve God in truth, in spirit, in holiness, in righteousness. And I pray, Lord Almighty God, have mercy upon such people. Touch their heart today. Give them the conviction so that they will know where they are is the wrong place. Is the wrong place. Come to Jesus today. That is the only way that will lead you to eternal life. That is the only way that leads you back to your Father in heaven. John chapter 14 verse 6. Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man, mark it, no man cometh unto the Father but by me. No man cometh to the Father. No man cometh to the Father. Not through Islam. If there are other religions, Jesus has made it clear. This is a unique Son of God. This is a unique child of God, you need our Father that is talking to us here. If there is other way, Jesus would have mentioned I and, or and I. He would have mentioned that name and said himself. But he said no. He didn't mention such things. No man cometh unto the Father but by me, by Jesus. So, Islam is a fake religion. They should stop fighting for devil. The foundation of Islamic religion is the devil, is satanic. They should stop fighting for the devil, their master. Those in that religion, open your eyes. They are not teaching you the truth. They have blinded you people and teaching you people the wrong thing. Ishmael wasn't the covenant child. It was Isaac. So repent today. Come to the right way. Embrace Jesus. He's not willing any should perish, but all should come to repentance. Unless you have decided to perish in your ignorance, or in your negligence, or your natural attitude, but it's not the fault of our Master. He has given everyone the opportunity and the privilege that you have to know the truth. The Bible says you shall know the truth and the truth shall set you free. Know the truth today that Christianity is the only approved religion that can lead you to everlasting life, that can lead you back to the Father. Your personal relationship with Jesus will lead you to everlasting life. I didn't say you just come to, you should be a church goer and come into Christendom and that is what will lead you to eternal life. No. You must repent of your sins and then embrace Jesus as a personal Lord and Savior. And come out from that wrong and false religion you are today, because the Lord wants you to be saved. I want to prove it to you. Ezekiel chapter 33, we're reading from verse 11. Ezekiel chapter 33 verse 11. Say unto them, as I live, says the Lord God, I have no pleasure in the death of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from his way and live, turn you from your evil ways. For why will you die, O house of Israel? Why will you die? Those in Judaism, why will you die in your ignorance? Those in Islamic religion, why should you die in your sins? Those in Buddhism, why should you die? Those in Hindu, why should you die? Hinduism, why should you die in your ignorant ways, in your simple ways? Come up and embrace Jesus. Come up and receive him as your personal Lord and Savior. Why are you serving the gods are made by your hands? When there is a living God, the true God, everlasting Father, there for you. The Lord is waiting for you. You have to repent today. Repent of your sins. Repent of the evil religion you are today. Please, I'm pleading to you. Let the Holy Spirit give you the conviction. I am not protecting Christianity because I'm a Christian. No. I was not in Christianity before. But by the grace of God, I have received Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior. The Holy Ghost has given me the conviction. Pray. He will give you the conviction too, so that you will receive him. This is the truth. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the life. Jesus is the way. He is the one that gave himself for us. None of this religion offered gave themselves for their worshippers. But Jesus did that because of the love he has for mankind. Not willing any should perish, but all should come to repentance. We see it today. Why should you die in that your fake false religion when Jesus has done it all for us? Notice to pray. Let the Holy Spirit reveal it to you. Do not let Satan to deceive you, to just put you in that, in those fake and false religions. And you're thinking you're serving God through those means. You are not serving the living God. You are serving gods that are made by hands of men. The gods that have men, they do not speak. They have no voice, they do not breathe. They have the power of the body, but they are dead. They cannot function. They cannot deliver. They cannot serve. I want to point out to you the state of such gods today, and the consequence upon those people that are following them today. But I know that as I speak, the Holy Spirit will give you the conviction, and you're going to take the step and be saved from such evil ways in the name of Jesus. Let's read Isaiah chapter 8, reading from verse 19. And when they shall say unto you, seek unto them that have familiar spirits, and unto wizard that peep, and that mortal, should not a people seek unto their God for the living to the dead? To the Lord and to the testimony. If they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. There is no light in them. And they shall pass through it, hardly be stayed and hungry. And it shall come to pass that when they shall be hungry, they shall fret themselves and curse their kings and their gods, and look upwards. Do you see it? That is what the Bible is telling us in verse 22. And they shall look unto the earth and behold trouble and darkness, dimness of anguish, and they shall be driven to darkness. That is a situation of other religion. The Lord is calling on you today. Jesus is a way. We are telling this because we have experienced it. It is truth. I am telling you the reality. And those of you fighting for your girls and fighting for your so-called religion, stop that. Stop killing souls. That should not kill. Don't kill human beings like you. We are teaching you today that God will open your eyes so that you come out from that dark place you are, that darkness you are, and come to serve the living God. Come to serve the true God. Come to serve the everlasting Father. Come to serve the creator of the entire universe. Come to serve he that is the almighty God. And stop serving the gods that are made by men. The guns that are formed elsewhere, modern elsewhere, they are dead, they are useless. In 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. The Lord willing that everyone should come to repentance. So you that over there, you that thinking you're fighting for your gods, you're fighting for your religion, come up. Come up to Jesus. He's calling unto you. He said, come unto me, all you that labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Matthew chapter 11, verse 28 to 30. Today, arise, receive Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. Come out from those falsehoods, and you, your life will never be the same. I want to prove to you that we are serving the true God. I want to prove to you that Jesus is the true God, the everlasting God, the King of glory. In Isaiah, in Jeremiah chapter 10, reading from verse 10, but the Lord is a true God. He is a living God, an everlasting King, and at his wrath the earth shall tremble, and the nations shall not be able to abide his indignation. Thus shall you say unto them, the gods that have not made the heaven and the earth, even they shall perish from the earth and from under this heaven. He has made the earth by his power. He has established the world by his wisdom and has stretched out the heavens by his description. So this is our God, the God we are serving through his Son, our Master, Jesus Christ. Therefore, today, I put it up to you as a challenge. There is no other God elsewhere. It's a God that answers by fire. He answered Elijah by fire. He's the living God. He's the true God. Look unto him and be you saved, all the heirs of the earth, for he's a God, there is no one else. There's no one else, no other God elsewhere. No other God can save you. He is the only, the true God, the only, the living God, the everlasting Father. Stop serving gods made by men's hands. Stop following Islamic religion. The Muslim hear this message today. Holy Spirit will give you conviction as you are hearing my voice. And you will know that what I'm speaking to you is the truth. And this truth will set you free. And will deliver you from that hell you're going. From that false hold you're holding onto. And God will see you through in the name of Jesus. Shall we pray? Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you for all my hearers today. Lord, that you have proved to us that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Every other one in other religion, they are fake and false. Father, I pray, Lord, open your eyes, give them the conviction to know this truth, that you are the living God, the true God, everlasting Father, that through your Son Jesus we can return to you, and not through any other means, that they will accept Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior today, and repent of their evil ways, and repent of their sinful ways, in the name of Jesus. My God, my Master, my Creator, blessed be your holy name. Prove to the whole world, prove to the whole nations, that you are the mighty God, you are the everlasting Father. You have made only one way out for us to serve you, for us to follow you, for us to return to you. That is your Son Jesus. I give you praise. I worship at your feet. Blessed be your holy name, Father. Blessed be the name of the Lord our God, who lives and reigns forevermore. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for you have heard my prayers. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Those people, Lord, let them be free. All those matters, they're killed for your name's sake, Lord. Let me this gentle soul rest in perfect peace. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. I point it out to you Muslims today. Stop killing. Stop those killing. Stop it. If your God be the living God, let him fight for himself. Stop those hearing all those battles you're doing. Because you know it, that you are in the wrong place. Devil is using your people greatly. You have made yourself as an instrument of destruction. Stop this evil you are doing. I speak out as a servant of the Lord. The wrath of God abides upon every one of you. You are cursed, people, because you are in the wrong place. That is why you are cursed. And you, until you repent, you cannot come out from the curse of God. You cannot come out from that evil way. Repent today and come and receive Jesus as a personal Lord and Savior. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. See you some other time. Amen.